बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव स्टार्टेड चैप्टर नंबर 5 विच इज़ लिक्विड्स, एंड प्रीवियसली वी हैव डिस्कस्ड वन लेक्चर एंड इट वाज अबाउट द केएमटी ऑफ लिक्विड्स एंड डिफरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ लिक्विड्स इंक्लूडेड देयर बिहेवियर, हाउ डू दे बिहेव, हाउ देयर मॉलिक्यूल्स आर अरेंज्ड एंड सो ऑन। दैट वाज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दैट चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 5 विच इज़ लिक्विड। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द टाइप्स ऑफ इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्सेस विच आर इन्वॉल्व इन द लिक्विड्स एंड हाउ डू दे इफेक्ट द इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्सेस। प्लस वी विल डिस्कस दैट हाउ दीज द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ द लिक्विड अफेक्ट देयर बॉन्डिंग्स एंड देयर बिहेवियर्स। टोटल वी हैव 5 टाइप्स ऑफ, एज यू कैन सी वी हैव 5 टाइप्स ऑफ इंटरमोलिकुलर फोर्सेस विच आर इन्वॉल्व इन द लिक्विड्स। We have dipole-dipole force, we have ion-dipole force, we have dipole-induced dipole force, we have London dispersion force, and we have hydrogen bonding. And we are going to start discussing all of them in, we will try to cover all of them, and we will cover few of them in detail. So first of all, we have dipole-dipole force, and the question is what dipole is. So we all know that all the elements, for example, if you can see here, we have example of HCl, or we have different kind of arrangement of the different molecules. If we are talking about two different elements, for example, we have hydrogen example and we have chlorine example. This hydrogen present in the group 1 and this chlorine present in the group 7. So the elements which are present in group 7 and the elements which are present in group 1, they have a huge electronegativity difference. Huge electronegativity difference. Now the first question is, what is electronegativity? Electronegativity is the tendency to attract share pair of electron. For example, this 7, this chloride which is having a 7 electrons in its outermost shell, it has 7, you can say it has 7 people who are pulling that one hydrogen, one electron of that hydrogen. For example, here we have just one person who is pulling the rope, and here we have how many people? We have 7 people. They are pulling this rope toward itself. So we know very well who will win. Obviously, the people who are maximum in number, they will win, and they will pull out the electron or pull out the rope toward itself. So they will win. So similarly, it goes with the element case also. If we have two different elements, they have a huge electronegativity difference. For example, this chloride is belonging from 7A group. It has 7 electrons. It has 1 electron. So it will attract electron of hydrogen, and there will be a sharing of electron occurred here. But this sharing causes, obviously, that there is a sharing of electron. But because of this huge electronegativity difference, because of this bigger electronegativity difference, this chloride will contain negative charge, and this hydrogen will start containing positive charge. Now what we can say, that this chloride is having a negative pole and this hydrogen is having a positive pole. So there is a dipole created. Dipole means we have two poles created here. One is negatively charged particle and a negatively charged pole, and the next one is positively charged pole. So how many poles we have? We have two poles. So this is known as dipole dipole interaction. Okay, so in that part, which is the first property we are discussing, the attractive forces between the positive ends of one molecule with the negative end of the other molecule are called dipole-dipole forces, and I have explained why these dipole forces are generated. This means dipole-dipole interactions are electrostatic interactions between permanent dipole in molecules. Example of polar molecule including HCl, hydrogen chloride, chloroform, and acetone. Note, stronger these dipole forces, greater would be the value of thermodynamic parameters like melting point, boiling point, heat vaporization, and etc. Okay, so that was the example of dipole-dipole interaction. Now comes London dispersion forces. What are London dispersion forces actually? London dispersion force is actually generated between homonuclear molecules. For example, In the previous part, in the dipole-dipole interactions, we have discussed about the different elements which are united here, which are united together. For example, we were discussing HCl or we were discussing HF and so on. We have many different, for example, we have water. We have discussed all these examples. But when it comes to lerner dispersion forces, so here we are, as you can see, we have example of two helium atoms. We have this one helium atom and we have this one helium atom. We will say that these two helium atoms, no doubt, helium is a zero group element. Helium is a noble gas. It doesn't react because its duplet is complete. All these properties are fine. We will not say that they are wrong, but there is some kind of phenomena. There is some kind of phenomena occurs in helium, and which causes helium for a while. Bit one helium will contain a negative charge and the second helium will contain positive charge. And we will discuss how this phenomena occur. That how this noble gas, which is a helium, which duplet is complete, how it behaves in that way. So, let's we start. We all know that all the electrons which are present in the atom, they revolve around the nucleus, and that's what we know all. For example, here we have helium, and on the second part we have helium again. Similarly, this procedure continues here. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Okay, so let me draw a diagram so that the picture should be clear to you. Let's we take, okay, this is one helium atom and it is having nucleus, and it is the example of second helium atom and it is having nucleus. Okay, so suppose kijiye that we have this nucleus, it has one electron present here and the second electron present here, and on the nucleus of on the atom these two electrons are present here. Okay, so this helium is containing two positive charge, and obviously this helium is also having atomic number plus two. For the time being, these two electrons which are present here, they will attract, because this part is empty right now. The electron of this helium are present here, so the space present here is empty right now. So what will happen, that these electron will start attracting the nucleus, the positive nucleus of the second helium. For the time being, due to this attraction, this helium will be having a bit for a while. It's not a permanent procedure, as I am repeating again, it's a very short procedure, but for the time being, this helium will contain a negative charge, and due to the pulling out, because this helium is taking away or attracting the nucleus of this second helium, so it will contain positive charge. So whole this procedure, this is known as, and this force of attraction which is creating here is known as Lerner dispersion forces. Let's we have a reading of that particle part now. What is written here? The forces of attraction between non-polar molecule which become polar for an instant are called Lerner dispersion forces. Explanation: substance like hydrogen, helium, neon, argon, chlorine, fluorine, methane, etc. are non-polar in nature. These gases can be liquefied and solidified under appropriate conditions. Some forces must be holding these molecules in contact with another in a liquid and solid state. In helium gas, on the average, the electron charge density is evenly distributed in a spherical region about the nucleus. However, at any given instant, the actual location of two electrons can influence the distribution of electrons in neighboring helium atom. And what they are discussing? They are discussing that same part which I was explaining to you, that two electrons are present here and two electrons are present here, and these electrons will start attracting the nucleus of the second helium. or the positive charge of the second helium. So due to this procedure, this will contain a positive charge, this will contain a negative charge, and the force of attraction which is between an instant dipole is and an induced dipole are known as dispersion forces, and it is also called London dispersion forces. And this is what I have explained with the diagrams to you. Hopefully this is clear to you all. On the next slide, we have factors that can affect London dispersion forces, and we have total three factors which can affect London dispersion forces. We have atomic or molecular size, we have polarizability, and we have number of atoms in a molecule. And all these three factors, if we are discussing them one by one, the strength of London dispersion forces depend upon the size of the electronic cloud. Inert gases are all monoatomic gases. They do not make any covalent bond with other atoms because of their valence shells are complete. Their boiling point increases down the group from helium to radon. This is because of increase in molecular size. And this is the table for boiling points of noble gases. Then we have a polarizability. Polarizability is of an atom or a molecule is a measure of the ease within one electron charge density is distorted. Large atom has more electrons and large electron cloud than smaller atoms. In large atom, the outer electrons are more loosely bounded, so they can shift toward another atom. It means that we have large atoms, they have loosely bonded nucleus, like they have a huge distances because of the shielding effects, so the attraction between nucleus and the outermost shell electron is weaker, so they can easily be distorted with any of the different for example any of the neighboring, if there is any neighboring electrons who want to attract these electrons, so they can attract them. Fine, so this is the concept here. And last part is number of atoms in a molecule. Elongated molecule may contact with neighboring molecule over a greater surface than two smaller molecules. This is the main concept. Greater the number of atoms in a molecule, greater is the polarizability of the molecule. Next we have a hydrogen bonding. And hydrogen bonding, we all know that what hydrogen bonding is actually. Hydrogen bondings is the kind of bonding. It is again intermolecular forces of attraction, and it is what happens actually, that we know very well that water has oxygen, one oxygen and two hydrogens present in them. So these oxygens which are present here has two lone pairs. Okay, so these two lone pairs are responsible. They are not satisfied, you can say, with these hydrogens. So what they do, what they want actually, what they start doing, that they start attracting the, like we have so many water molecule present here, we don't have just one water molecule here, we have so many water molecule. So due to the presence of this lone pair which is present here, this lone pair will start attracting the hydrogen of any of the other hydrogen water molecule. And similarly, this oxygen, it is also having two lone pair, it will start attracting the electrons of any other hydrogen like this. Similarly, this oxygen is again will start making a weak bonding with any of the water molecule. This whole phenomena which I am showing here with the dotted line is known as hydrogen bonding. As you can see, here we have example. Here we have this water molecule. It is having a covalent bonding. This is the example of covalent bonding. And due to the presence of a lone pair which is present, it has two lone pairs actually, it will start attracting the hydrogen of any of the water molecule. Similarly, this oxygen is also doing the same procedure. This oxygen, these all oxygens are doing the same procedure. And this hydrogen bonding is represented with the dotted line. What this dotted line shows? This dotted line shows weaker force of attraction. And weaker force of attraction means that all these intermolecular forces which we are studying here are having weak force of attraction. Hopefully these things are clear to you. In the next class, we will discuss about applications of hydrogen bonding in detail. That's all for today. अल्लाह हाफिज़।